guys who don't know English, right? So one of the things, you statements you made that with India and China becoming a global superpower, right?
Mm.
It might benefit it. But what I see is it might hamper this more, right? I mean, as it becomes a global power and it becomes more closer to the Western stuff, English might take on the place of a lot of these scripts, and we might lose a lot of these languages, right?
That's a good point, but who's to say that Westernization or modernization
rising? I don't say that. I'm just saying.
No, I'm not saying that you're saying it, but I'm saying who is to say that that's what's going to happen? That English is going to be the major language?
Yeah,
because a lot of people are saying that.
I'm seeing it in my own village.
Happens in India much more than it does in China.
In China, it doesn't happen.
The language
didn't develop that fast.
It's like
we
tend to be quite malleable about.
Sure,
it's not in the language I speak, and it's in English.
The default Windows sold in India is in English, but in China
it's in Chinese.
Right, because Indians did not enforce these things at the time.
Also, we have far too many languages. So even if the Union government decides to, it needs to do it in 15 languages at the same time, which is not as easy as doing it in one.
Right, and it's a political thing. I mean, they say that they want to make Kannada part of everything, but it's a political thing. It's got nothing to do with actual...
I think it's not even political, it's about money. See, simple thing is that if you are...
But, no, I mean, it's
so I think we can take that off.
That's a good point to make.
In context.